Very good morning, everyone. In our previous three lectures, we have completed the practicals based on the location, based on the different kinds of API, based on the notification. We have also developed application based on services and JSON parsing. So, unit number 4 is completed, but one theoretical point which can be asked in exam, publish Android application, that is the last topic of unit number 4. So that theory portion I am going to explain in our today's session. So let us begin with the theoretical portion of how to upload your application on Play Store. So there are several requirements, there are several steps which you need to follow so that you can upload your application in the Play Store. Now let us begin with the introduction portion, that after the application design, application implement, then testing, then debugging, now your application are ready to upload on your Google Play Store. That is the first point. Once you have designed, implemented, tested and debug your application, you are ready to upload your application on Google Play Store. This information will help you to publish your application very easily and quickly on Google Play Store. Here are the list of steps in this session I am going to explain, using which you can easily upload your application in the Google Play Store. To upload your application on the Google Play Store, you need to have Android application project using any application, like if you use Eclipse or you use Android Studio. Next is what? If you have already created some APK, which we always create in the unit number 4, right? I have told you how to generate APK file, how to store, install it into the computer, into your device, right? That portion I have already completed. So if you have already APK available, you can directly upload it into the Google Play Store. So there are two ways using which you can upload your application in the Play Store. Either you need to create application in Eclipse or you need to have .apk generated file. Next requirement is what? You need to have internet connection. So this is the basic requirement which you need to have, because otherwise you are not able to upload your application on the Play Store. So internet connection is compulsory, or we can say must. Next is called credit card or debit card. Why credit card or debit card? Because at the first time when you are going to create the account on a Google Play Store, at that time you need to purchase a license of Google developer. So you need to pay for that. And in the very beginning, in the unit number 1, at that time I have told you that approximately $25 lifetime validity is there for Android, right? So if you pay that much dollar, at that time you will get lifetime validity of your account. So for that you need to have credit card or debit card. Next is called screenshots. Now see, whatever the application you are trying to upload in your Play Store, that application's screenshot must be taken, and approximately at least 2 screenshots are compulsory regarding your application, because when you launch your application in the Google Play Store, at that time at least 2 screenshots you need to upload. So that is again another requirement to upload your application in the Google Play Store. Next is called, if you already have APK file available in the computer, at that time you may switch to the step number 10. Here are the list of steps, approximately 21 steps are there, right? So you need to follow 21 steps to publish your Android application. But if you have APK ready, at that time you can start with the step number 10. Otherwise, you need to follow above 9 steps. So let us start with the step number 1, that is called Open Eclipse. Eclipse is a workspace in which you are going to develop your application. So Open Eclipse with workspace containing the application project that you want to upload on Google Play Store. So using Eclipse, you need to open your application. Now, what is the next step? That is step number 2, select export. That means select your project, right click on your project and select export option from the list. Now you need to select export type in the third step. Let me repeat first two step once again. Step number 1, you need to open Eclipse to open your application. Now second step is what? You need to select export option. For that you need to right click on your project, you need to click on select export. Now what is the third step? Select export type. For that, open folder titled Android. Now you need to open Android folder. In that, select export Android application option. Now click on next. One dialog box will come which contains label or title as a export Android application will be replacing the old one. So this is the third step in which you need to select the export type of your application. And for that, what you need to do, you need to click on Android folder, you need to select an export Android application, click on next button. When you click on next, at that time export Android application will be replaced by the old one, right? Now what is the fourth step? Now you need to check for the errors which is inside your application. So for that, the export Android application, this is the third step, right? So over here we will continue with that dialog box. It will check for the errors which is there in the project. If your project does not contain any error, at that time you will get one message, no errors found. Let me repeat this step once again. The fourth step is called checking for errors. In this, export Android application dialog box will be there. In that, you need to check for errors in the project. When you click on it, at that time it will check for the errors available inside the application. And if your application does not contain any error, that means your project is error free, at that time you will get message, no errors found. Now you need to click on next. So click on next if the project is free. There is one note. If your project contains error, you need to fix them up first and then start with the exporting process again. So if there is a two possibility of checking for errors. Number one, if no error found in the application, at that time you need to click on next button. But if your project contains error, in such cases, you need to fix them first and then again you need to start with the exporting process. So this is the fourth step. Fifth step is entering a key store. Now see, key store is what? It is a type of account which is in the encrypted mode stamp onto the final application file. Now see, if you do not created key store at that time, you can create it with the radio button for create new key store. So there is one option button or radio button available in the dialog screen in which you can click on the create new key store. When you are going to select this option? When you do not have key store created previously, right? So if you already have key store, at that time don't select this option. But if you do not have created a key store, at that time you need to click on a radio button which contains create new store. Here is a note that if you have created key store previously, means I have previously stored key store available in my computer, at that time what you need to do, you need to enter the name of that key store and password of that particular key store, and you need to skip these two steps and you can directly switch into the step number 8. But right now I don't have any key store available in the computer, so I am going to create it with the checking of radio button on create new key store. Now what I need to do, I need to create a new key store by clicking on a browse button, select a location to store your new key store file. That means you need to select browse option for the location on which you want to save your file. Generally, key store can be saved in the same directory where you have your project files. Give a name and select save option. I want to repeat step number 5 once again. This step is related with key store. If you already have key store, at that time you can directly switch on to the step number 8. Suppose you do not have key store available in the computer, at that time you need to create new key store, and new key store can be created using create new key store. That is the step number 6. For creation of new key store, you need to save it on some location of your computer, and generally you can save it on the same directory on which your project files are saved. So in future it is easy to find out key store. For that purpose only you need to refer the same location. Now you need to give a name of your key store and you need to click on a save button. When you click on a save button, at that time you need to choose a particular password for the particular available key store. But remember that you need to remember this password because it will be asked in, it may ask in the future. So if you lose your key store password, you will not be able to release an update for your application in future. So if any update is there in your application in future and you want to make update of your application and you do not have the password of your key store, at that time you are not able to release the update of your application. So for that purpose you need to remember the password of your key store. So these 3 points are related with the key store. Even choosing an alias means another name, right? So, or we can call it as a nickname. So now you need to fill alias, password and validity fields on the key encryption screen. You also need to fill at least one field from the certificate issuer section, it's a good idea to use your name for the alias because it is very easy to remember and will never be displayed. So remember one thing, that when you choose any name as a alias name, it gives you the suggestion that as a alias, better you give your name as a alias. Why? Because it is easy to remember. And this particular alias are never displayed on the screen. So you do not need to worry regarding the name of the alias you have given. Again, choose a password that you can remember. As I have told you that when any update is there regarding the application, in future you are not able to update your application if you do not remember the password. So be careful while choosing the password. The number that you choose to enter in the validity field will be the number of years for which your application is available on the Google Store. So in this, you also need to select the year, that this number of years my application will be there in the Google Store. So after completion of that much year, your application will be automatically deleted from the Google Store. So validity of your application you need to select in the choosing an alias. Next is called choose file export destination. So in this, see, this is the step number 9. We need to, if we already have developed application, we can start from the step number 10. So what is the first step number 9? You need to choose your APK file to export in the destination. So this is the last step in exporting your application, is to click on browse, select the destination to store APK of your project, click on finish and export file, and then exit Eclipse. So here the role of Eclipse is completed. Now here given are the below steps where the APK is generated, and now we are going to upload our APK file into the Google Play Store. So for that, the first step is what? Go to the Google developer site. This is the first step if you already have APK file installed in the computer. And if you do not have generated APK, then you need to follow above 9 steps to generate APK. Open Eclipse, select export type, checking for the errors, entering a key store, creating a new key store, choosing a password, and choosing an alias. And last is called choosing file for the export destination. So these 9 are the steps which you need to follow when your APK file is not ready, right? After completion of the 9th step, you are having APK file which you need to upload in the Google Play Store. So for that, either 1st or 10th step is go to the Google developer site. So for that, open browser and search for a developer console, Google Play, and navigate to the same. Navigate means to move on to the same page. Now step number 11 is what? Login into developer account. As I have told you that you need to have a credit card or debit card requirement through which you are able to pay, and approximately $25 provide you the lifetime validity of Google developer account. So if you do not have Google developer account at that time, you are not able to upload your application in the Play Store. So for that, login if you already have a Google developer account. If you do not have an account, follow the steps below to create the Google developer account. Click on a sign up in the top right corner of the screen and follow the rest of the steps In the last step, you need to pay $25 one time for creating the account by credit card or debit card. I hope this point is clear, that when you have developer account, then only you are able to upload application on the Google Play Store. So this is the reason why I have taken the theory session of this particular topic, because we do not have Google developer account. So I am not able to show the practicals based on how to publish application in the Play Store, right? So better the theory concept I can clear so that you can write in the exam. Next is called adding a new application. Now see, when you want to add new application, at that time click on the blue button labeled plus add new application in the console. So in the console you need to choose add new application. After that you need to upload the APK file. So for that, in the add new application dialog box, select the required language from the drop down menu, and then the name of your application as you want it to appear in the Google Play Store, and then select upload APK button. Now you will be diverted to a new home page for your application. So over here you can give the name of your APK file, which can be, that name will be displayed on the Google Play Store. So that name you need to give over here. Next is called initiating APK upload part 2. On this, over here, see, the new home page for your application will be opened. So now what happens, on the new home page of your application, select the button which contains upload your first APK to the production. So you need to click on this particular button. When you click on that button, at that time select an upload APK file. Now you need to click on a browse button for browsing of your document or browsing of your APK file. So click on browse to browse or surfing for APK file. Now next step is, status of uploading is shown in the status bar. So in this step you are going to upload your APK file on the Google Play Store. So definitely it will take some time to upload your application on the Play Store. So some status of your uploading is shown in a progress bar. Progress bar we have already completed in the practical session. So you can understand that progress bar shows the progress of your uploading, right? So you will get that progress bar. After that, add description to your project. This is very important point. Why? Because you, after uploading of APK, there is a time to give the description regarding the application. So description needs to be added to the store listing page, which is found by navigating the tabs on the left. Type of application description in the description text box. This description will appear in Google Play Store on the page for your application. So this is very important. If your description is powerful, at that time many of people is going to download the application on the device. So definitely you will get benefit of the same. So be careful while giving the description regarding the project. Next is called add screenshot of your application. At the very beginning I have told you that at least 2 or 3 screenshots you need to have regarding your application. So the next step is to add sample screenshot of your application. To upload the screenshot, scroll down and click on one of the three plus add screenshot buttons corresponding to the all type of devices they were taken on. So minimum two, but if you have many screenshots regarding the application, you can upload it over here, right? A dialog will appear allowing you to select the screenshot from a directory on your computer. So dialog box will allow you to select all the screenshot which is available on a computer. Next step is adding an icon to your application. This is again very powerful feature. You can upload icon related to the applications. Generally, any application belongs from a particular company. At that time, the logo of that company is displayed as an icon of the application. So, icon is the main picture that pop-ups at the top of the screen in the Google Play Store with the application name. Whenever the browse button is clicked, a dialog box will open allowing you to select the icon in the same way as you select screenshot in step number 7. That means in previous step we have click on browse button and we click on add screenshot buttons. So from that I am able to add screenshot regarding my applications. Similarly, if I want to add icon, at that time one dialog box will open from where I can choose my icon regarding the application, and that is the main picture which will be displayed in the top of the screen in Google Play Store. So be careful, select a particular picture which contains a good quality of image. Next is called filling details. The final step on the store listing page is filling out the categorization, contact detail and privacy policy. Fill out the required fields according to your discretion and click on save button. The store listing tab should now have a green check mark next to it. That means now you need to fill some details regarding privacy of your application. You need to fill out contact details. You need to select the categories from the list. So step number 19 is a collection of selection of categories, contact details and privacy policy. Next step is called pricing and distribution. Now over here, when you click on this tab, you will select paid or free distribution countries and checkboxes saying that your application complies with the content guidelines and US export laws. So over here you need to select in which country you need to display this particular application. Even your application is a paid application or free application, that you need to select from this step. And now you need to click on a save button. At last, publishing your app is the 21 point and last point. Once all the three tab of left have green check mark, that means you can select publish this app, and now your app is ready to publish. Drop down menu in the top right hand corner side of the developer console. A confirmation bar will appear at the top indicating that your application will be available in the Play Store in just a few hours. So for watching the application in the Google Play Store, now you need to wait for few hours to complete the whole process. So these 21 are the steps which you need to follow to publish your Android application on your Google account. Let me repeat this 21.1 once again. First of all, we have started with the introduction portion. There are 2 points. Number one, after design, implemented, testing and debugging of your application, now your application is ready to upload on the Google Play Store. Now, this particular information will help you to publish your application very easily and quickly on the Google Play Store. There are several things you require when you are going to upload your application on a Google Play Store. The first application is first requirement is called Eclipse. Second is called APK file. Third is called internet connection. Fourth is called credit card or debit card to purchase a Google developer license. Fifth one is called screenshots. Approximately, you require to have 2 screenshots regarding the application, which is compulsory. Sixth point is what? If you already have .apk file, at that time you can directly switch to the step number 10. But right now, say for example, I don't have any APK generated regarding my application, so you need to generate it first. So for that, open Eclipse, select export type. You need to check for the errors available in the project. Suppose your project does not contain any error, you need to click on next button. If your project contains any error, at that time you need to correct it, and again you need to follow the step number 1. Fifth step is called entering a key store. If you already have a created key store, you can upload it over here and you can go to the step number 8. But if you want to create new key store, at that time you can click on a create a new key store button. When you click on it, you will get browse button. You need to select the location on which you want to save your key store file. But generally, you can store it into the same directory where your project file is stored. And now you need to click on a save button. Next step is called choosing a password. In this, you need to select that password which you can easily remember, because in future if you want to provide any updates regarding the application, you must have password, otherwise you are not able to update it. Next is called choosing an alias. Alias is the another name. Generally, it gives you the suggestion that you can give your name as an alias, so it is easy to find the name from the alias. And this alias will never be displayed on any place. So it keeps a secret name. Next is called choose file export destination. This is the place from where you can store your file, APK file, on the computer. Now you need to click on a finish button and you need to exit from the Eclipse. There are several steps which you need to follow to upload your APK file on a Google Play Store. Now our APK is ready up to step number 9. So first of all, we need to go to the developer console available in the Google Play. Now we need to login to the Google developer account. Now see, if I already have a Google developer account, then I can login in it. But say for example, first time I am going to upload my application, so for that I need to sign up. And when you sign up for the first time, you need to pay $25, which gives you the lifetime validity of developer account. Next is called adding a new application. You can add new application by clicking on the add new application button. Next is called initializing APK upload. In this, you need to initialize your APK in two parts. First part is upload APK, and second part is called upload your first APK to the production. Now, next is called select and upload APK file. So you need to click on a browse button to select your APK file, which is generated by either Eclipse or any other Android Studio or any other emulator. Next is called add description to your project. This is very important step because description will be displayed when user is going to search on a Google Play Store. Next is called add screenshot of your application. You can take a screenshot of your application and you can display on the, you can add it onto the application in this particular step, and minimum two image you need to upload. Next is called filling detail, which contains information and selection regarding categories, regarding contact detail and privacy policy of your application. Next is called pricing and distribution. In this, you can select that your application is belongs from the paid application or free application, or you can also select the country of your distribution application. And the last step is publishing your application. You can click on ready to publish from the drop-down menu, which is available on the corner of your developer console. So you need to wait now for the few hours to upload your application in the Google Play Store. So these all are the steps related with the how to publish your Android application in the Google Play Store. Compulsory, you need to purchase a license, you need to create the Google developer account, and for that you need to pay $25, which gives you the lifetime validity. So this is the theoretical aspect. Over here we have completed unit number 4, and in our next video I am going to start with the unit number 3, which is related with the database connectivity using SQLite and content provider, which is very much important unit based on the practical aspect of practical of exam. Till there, goodbye everyone. Thank you all.